Today in court, fellow inmate Nathan Ermine pleaded guilty to manslaughter in the death of Cornell Henry. Ermine did not admit to delivering the fatal blows to Henry's head, but he did admit he blocked the door of Henry's cell. For that and other crimes, including a non-lethal assault against another inmate, Ermine was sentenced to 9 years in jail. Today's court hearing also revealed details about curious procedural lapses at the jail the day Henry died. A jail worker misplaced Henry's private file that day so that it circulated among other inmates, including the accused. Court also heard that after Henry's body was tucked into his bunk, guards didn't discover he was injured for hours, even though they'd already done visual inspections of his cell. Today, Henry's father said the jail should have done better.
It's a, what do you call it, a look on, look see. You look in, you see he's there, and walk away, and they don't check. Unfortunately, he was there for 2 hours without being looked at, or is that the only way they found out that he was hurt is when he wasn't checking in for his meds.
I'm disappointed in the Saskatoon Correctional Centre and their ability to keep inmates safe. It's a dangerous place, and I think they should be having a much higher attention to detail, but I'll let another court or another inquiry comment further on that.
Henry's father says he's now considering legal action against Saskatchewan's Ministry of Corrections. The day Henry died wasn't the first time that Saskatoon correctional workers acted in a less than ideal fashion, according to the Crown. In fact, during a separate assault incident involving Ermine, it was a jail guard who let Ermine into his victim's cell. Guy Kenville, CBC News, Saskatoon.